My colleague Kamal Jeet is getting us more details on that story, joining us live right now. Kamal, in fact, as far as the mandi is concerned, this area, we have pictures, in fact, of Kangana Ranaut doing puja early today, is in fact an interesting and a tantalizing contest between Vikramaditya Singh and Kangana Ranaut. It remains to be seen whether first time candidate Kangana, who's just joined the BJP and got an opportunity to contest from here, is going to be able to in fact upset the apple cart of Vikramaditya here.
Well, Mandi is definitely the cynosure of the entire nation, with the fiercest battle being fought between the royal, which is Vikramaditya, versus the queen of Bollywood, Kangana Ranaut. Now, many in the Congress party feel that these are antics of Kangana Ranaut, because many a time she's made some controversial statements, literally being foot in mouth. That's what is drawing in the crowds, as alleged by the Congress party. Meanwhile, it does seem that Vikramaditya has put in a whole lot of strength. And then the BJP obviously relying on the Prime Minister's magic and his recent rally there, bringing in thousands and thousands of people. But on ground, people are really holding their card close to their chest. We just spoke to Sukhwinder Sukhu, the Chief Minister of Himachal Pradesh, who say, you know, we're going to send her back to Bollywood. She's a good actress. But when it comes to politics, you need a good director if you need to really perform well here. And so he believes that she may have come in on the popularity of Bollywood, but she's not going to really last here.
All right, I'm going to invite us to be with us. Kamal getting us up to speed with those details as far as Himachal Pradesh and the high-profile seat of Mandi here is concerned. Kamal, in fact, I'm going to thank you for the moment for that. Let's talk about Bihar now, which is also voting in the seventh and final phase of the Lok Sabha elections. The Chief Minister Nitish Kumar cast his vote in Bihar's Bakhtiarpur. Early morning, RJD Chief Lalu Yadav, along with his wife and former Bihar CM Rabri Devi, accompanied by their daughters Meesa Bharti and Rohini Acharya, came out and cast their vote in Patna Sahib. RJD star campaigner, son of Lalu Yadav, Tejasvi Yadav, arrived in a wheelchair to cast his vote with brother Tej Pratap Yadav. BJP candidate from Patna Sahib, Ravi Shankar Prasad, also arrived at the polling booth to cast his vote. Meanwhile, BJP-led NDA candidate Jitin Ram Manjhi cast his vote in Jehanabad and urged voters to exercise their franchise.
जो प्रधानमंत्री जो ध्यान लगा रहे हैं कन्याकुमारी में, उसको लेकर जबरदस्त राजनीति,
ये बहुत दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण है। प्रधानमंत्री योगी भी हैं, वो केदारनाथ में ध्यान लगा चुके हैं। ये तो सनातन का अपमान कर रहे हैं। आप करिए, आपको हिम्मत है तो करिए, कामना ही है। इस तरह का व्यंग करना ये शर्मनाक है।
मैं समझता हूँ कि पिछले दो बार से पाटलिपुत्र की महान जनता ने अपने सेवक को सेवा दिया है, सेवा का मौका दिया है, और मोदी जी नीतीश कुमार जी का जो विकास का काम है जन जन तक गया है। पहले भी सारे परिवार वाले पार्टी, ये तो परिवार वाली वाली पार्टी है ना, आप देखा नहीं चुनाव में कौन लोग घूम रहा था? अपने किसी भी उम्मीदवार के पक्ष में लोग नहीं घूमे, मगर मेरे यहाँ पाटलिपुत्र में पाटलिपुत्र की जनता से लड़ने के लिए ये लोग घूम रहे हैं।
मैंने अपना मत का प्रयोग किया यहाँ पे, और मैं सभी देशवासियों को, आज अंतिम चरण का चुनाव है, उनको कहूँगी कि अपने घरों से निकले और अपने अधिकार का प्रयोग करें, मत डालें।
सर, आपने वोट दे दिया है, क्या अपील करेंगे?
आप लोगों से अपील है कि बूथ के बूथ पर पहुँचे, लोकतंत्र के इस पर्व में हिस्सा लें, और संविधान, लोकतंत्र और आरक्षण जो खत्म करना चाहते हैं, जिन लोगों ने महंगाई, गरीबी, बेरोजगारी बढ़ाई है, उसके खिलाफ वोट का छूट करें।
आज अंतिम दौर में क्या उम्मीदें थे?
बीजेपी सफा चक,
बस आशीर्वाद मुझे मिल रहा है, मैं खुश हूँ।
लोगों से क्या कहना चाहेंगे सर, जो जिनके लिए वोट करने जाएंगे, उनसे क्या कहना चाहेंगे? लोगों से क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
आपन कीमती समय निकाल के आपन कीमती वोट हम सबसे निहोरा करब कि जरूर करी जा, वोट दी जा, वोट करी जा, आशीर्वाद दी जा।
But Aditya is getting us more details in that story. Aditya is joining us from Karakat in Bihar. Aditya, first of all, talk to us about your constituency and also the voting percentage up until now. Is there risk voting, so to speak?
Well, exactly, Sneha. As far as the voters' turnout is concerned, you can clearly see in the visuals that, of course, the increasing and soaring temperature is now taking toll on the voters' turnout as far as Karakat constituency is concerned. But then, that being said, the early hours were the hours actually which saw heavy turnout as far as the voters are concerned. And interesting to note here is the fact that this Karakat constituency is a fourth polar contest, and unlike any other constituency, apart from the NDA and Mahagathbandhan candidates that are Upendra Kushwaha and Raja Ram Singh, there are two more interesting candidates who are actually in the fray as far as Karakat constituency is concerned. But that being said, increasing temperature is a major menace, and we'll have to wait and see if at all the voters' turnout increases, because we've been noticing this time that voters' turnout is going a downhill trend, and which is something even the political parties are actually highlighting. But then we'll have to wait and see what actually happens, and if at all the voters start coming back to the polling stations in numbers. Sneha.
All right. I'm going to thank you for the moment for getting us up to speed with that, Aditya Vaibhav.